I would like to thank our hair and makeup partner for the day, Salon To Be by Michelle Odugama.
Hi everyone, welcome to the NG Youth on the Move new episode today. I'm Lehini Veerasinghe, and today too I do have an energetic young personality with me, and he is pretty splendid at what he does, and it's also something that we are not much used to. He's also from the field of science, and well, rather than I tell about him, I think it's best to ask him who he sees himself as. So welcome to the show, Amavin Mendes.
Thank you for having me here.
Okay. So would you like to, you know, tell us who you are in like the shortest time possible?
Yes.
An elevator pitch, if
yes.
I must.
Sure. Hi everyone, I'm Amavin Mendes. I went to Mahanama College and I recently started my degree at Slate doing biotechnology. So I'm very passionate about wildlife and photography. So I'm here to talk about my passion in the field. Though my academics are different from it, I'm very into understanding this beautiful wildlife in our country and enjoying the beauty of them through photography. I'm part of this research. I'm interning for this research called Urban Fishing Cat Conservation. So I just started interning there as well since I just finished my A-levels, and I have a lot of adventures to share with you.
Very interesting personality indeed. That's why I said he's one of a kind. His degree is in biotechnology, as I hear, but
yes.
He has this inquisitive nature about, I mean, he's very inquisitive about ecology and wildlife, as I hear. And he also says that his passion is photography. So very interesting, Amavin. Now, you were saying, now I wanted to highlight that part. You were saying that your academics is from a different field, although your passion is different. So what made you choose your academic field, and how come it is different from your passion and you're still like doing it?
Yeah, honestly, so biotechnology has always been one of the things I'm very interested about. I'm especially interested about genes and how they are expressed. So that was my career goal growing up. But animals have always been part of my life since I was very young. I had my first pet. It was a turtle when I was about 3 years old.
And sweet, what was his name?
It was Kimmer.
Okay.
So okay, he cool. lived with me for around 12 years. Then he sadly passed away. But through those 12 years, I've had a lot of animals in my life. Even my father was very interested in animals. So he let me have a lot of pets and enjoy. So if I give you a list, I had a dog, I had cats, I had a lot of fish. Then I had parrots, I had finches, I had rabbits, guinea pigs, hamsters, you name it, I've almost had everything, yeah.
It's so interesting.
So it is very interesting to have pets and learn to love an animal. And it's also a good opportunity to understand life, how sometimes things we love are very short-lived and we have to enjoy them while they last. So wildlife, talking about wildlife, since I was young, when I was in grade 3, I got this opportunity to join the Young Zoologist Association's junior members group. So from grade 1, I used to go to the zoo and learn about animals and participate in those activities. We went on a lot of field trips and I got a lot of knowledge through that. But after a while, with studies and everything, I was held back for a bit. Then when I was in grade 10, when I was like 15 years old, I joined the senior batch again. Okay. I was almost the youngest person there, but I tried to learn a lot, tried to learn as much as I can about the animals and to interact with them. So while I was there, I was part of this public education program where we used to take the eagles, the owls, and even serpents out sometime just to introduce them into the public and to educate them about them. So I was part of that program as well. And we also took part in various field trips where we went to Yala, we went to Ma Kandurava, and various other forests and reserves. So that is where I found the true passion for wildlife. And after a while, I even got myself a camera and started doing wildlife photography. And through that, I also got into birding, bird watching. And that's how my wildlife journey started.
Okay, that's I think that's like the gist of a truly passionate person, truly passionate animal lover. And Amavin, I really like the part where you said that we should learn to be compassionate from a very young age. I think by having a lot of pets, I think you had that upbringing where you were natural at loving animals, and which then, you know, build up, which then grew into this passion towards wildlife.
Yeah.
Right. Amavin, do you see any point where you can combine your passion and your field of studies?
So wildlife is honestly a huge field. So it's zoology, ecology, and there's a lot of genetics involved as well. So I'm planning on going into genetics. So through that, I can actually help wildlife in understanding the underlying genetics and how these animals have evolved. So these are all, science is a field which always mix and integrates. So I can always use the knowledge from my academics to apply it into my passion and help out everyone there.
Nice. So, but unfortunately, Amavin, in Sri Lanka, we have limited opportunities for people who are interested in learning science. That's the truth.
Yeah.
So I think right now you're studying at a private campus.
Yes, I am.
Right. So what is your take now? You're only in your 20s and you have this unending passion towards science, but you see not much of an opportunity out there. So what was your thought in getting into a degree? What do you see the situation like?
So the thing is, there are opportunities, but they're mostly hidden. So if you look into it, you might have a big chance of finding something you love to do. So in my case, I was at home after A-levels, obviously, waiting for my results. I was very fed up with COVID. I couldn't go out anywhere. So what I did is I just went on Instagram and saw this interview done by Raw Media with Anya Ratnayake. So she was talking about the research she's doing about urban wildlife in Colombo, the Urban Fishing Cat Project. So I was like very intrigued about this. So what I did was I started emailing her and DMing her. She didn't answer my DMs, but after I was pestering her for so long, she answered my emails and she was like, come in. So yeah, just send me a CV and we'll see about you joining the team. So opportunities are there, but you have to be very persistent in seeking them out.
And that leads me to the next question now. He's in his 20s and he said that he went on Instagram and that's how he found out this opportunity. So what is your take on social media? Are we making the right use of social media? What is your take, Amavin?
So social media, I view social media as a tool mostly because it's a very good way to connect with people. It's a very good way to promote your own brand, to get attention for the things you are doing. So I can see that as a very good tool to use to build something. But honestly, what I've seen through social media, most people, no hate to anyone, but most people are breaking each other down. They're not helping each other. There's zero compassion, just the views and the likes. So that's honestly sad, where we can actually use social media as a good thing to build our own brand as well as helping others. So that's honestly my take on social media.
Nice. Now, Amavin, now we were talking about science, we were talking about urban wildlife here in Colombo. I think most of your work is based here in Colombo. But are you happy with how people perceive science, as in especially as in science communication? Are we in the right track in science communication, or do you find it easier for you to explain to someone what you are doing, or do you have to struggle with it a lot because people are not very savvy about science?
Well, it is a struggle, but I've been taught to strike up a conversation and to relate to that person before bringing up facts and figures and statistics, because people connect to stories rather than numbers.
Very true.
So what I do is always when I go somewhere, I always try to talk to those people and ask them about whether they've seen any animals, and to let them know that there are a lot of animals around even this area. There's a lot of even fishing cats around this area. So what I do is always try to strike up a conversation and build a story and try to relate to those people to get the message across. In science, I've seen all these people try to go with the statistics, and that's honestly not the way to go. I don't see that as the way to go, because people can't relate to numbers. Mm-hmm. Even I find it very hard to relate to numbers sometimes.
Right.
But giving them a good story with a moral as well as something to connect to, that gets the message across much better. So even when it comes to COVID, I think it's better to approach it in a more emotional way rather than a very statistical way to promote this vaccination and everything.
Very nice. That's a very interesting take on it, Amavin, because what you said about adding the personal touch to any sort of communication, especially science communication, would actually be more impactful rather than just going with the facts and figures, which the layman cannot, which the people cannot understand. So I think we've talked a lot about science now. Yes. So we'll just, you know, we'll also add a personal touch to what we are trying to speak about today. So Amavin, now you're 20.
I'm 20.
20. Okay. So do you have a girlfriend? No.
That.
I should not be asking that.
Yeah.
But I will be asking this. So what is your idea on love and marriage? Because you're very young and world is changing, so there's a lot of concepts going on, so you know.
Honestly, love, the first thing I experienced was through my family. So I'm in a very supportive family. Honestly, they support me through everything, even though sometimes like I have made some mistakes, but they are very caring. So when I look at my parents, that's the first example of love I've seen. They are always like a team and very supportive of each other. And them both being very busy people, they always find time to spend together and even spend time with us. We always tend to have family dinner at home, sitting down. So that is the first example of love I've seen. So I view love as something of a partnership or something we do as a team. So when you talk about a relationship, I always see it as an opportunity to spend your emotions with another person and to relate to that person and help them grow, as well as bettering yourself with the help of that person, rather than just a deal. It's not a business deal. If you're fighting, honestly, I think you shouldn't, like, if the both the people are fighting, there would not be an end to it. So it's better to be receiving, more compassionate, and to understand the other person's viewpoint and approach it in a very compassionate way, rather than just being very big-headed and not seeing the other person, thinking that you're always right. So you should think of it in a very emotional way. I used to be very robotic. I used to be a person who only saw the science of stuff and the logic of it, but honestly, logic is just one part of it, but emotions are not a logical thing. So you have to relate to the person and be very compassionate. So that's my take on love.
That's nice. Now imagine, Amavin, now imagine your wife or your girlfriend achieving more than you do career-wise, because you are following your passion. So I see you more as a passionate human being who is not into the competitive world, like who is not in competition with anyone. That's how I see you from this short conversation that we had. So if your girlfriend or wife is performing more than you do in their particular field, what would you feel? Would you feel insecure?
I honestly think you should be happy. You just imagine your loved one is achieving. So that's good for you too. I see it as my achievement as well. I am helping that person. I always think that we should always help that person to grow. So them achieving something even better than me, and there's no competition between us. Honestly, in a relationship, I don't see us as individuals who are competing with each other, rather than just a unit who's working together to get the best out of everything. So I would not honestly feel anything bad about it. I would honestly help the person to achieve even more and support them. If they're missing out on something, I would go there and help out whenever I can, and make them feel better about themselves and motivate them to do more.
Now, there's this notion, girls should learn to cook. Girls are the ones who should be cooking in a relationship or in marriage. Yes. So, now you're 20. What is your fresh opinion on this one?
I think it's a life skill. Everyone should know how to cook.
Do you know how to cook?
Yes, I actually cook everything. Like at
That's
home,
nice.
I make Italian, I make Sri Lankan. Oh. I can honestly cook very well. So, I think it's a life skill. Everyone should learn. Cooking, cleaning, taking care of the house, basic, you know, basic handiwork. You should know how to do that. And I don't think something should be gendered, as in segregated into.
Stereotypical.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes. You shouldn't stereotype any genders into a certain gender role. I think that's a thing of the past. Mm. And we should move on from that and start understanding how the world works. And
yeah, that's great. That's actually great coming from a 20-year-old. So I see the future is really good for the youth because they think like this. So having said that, Amavin, now we do have an audience that comprises of different types of youth because we are catering to a wide sector, wide array of youth from different backgrounds. So overall, from your upbringing, from your academic and from your passion like in wildlife and ecology, from all the experience that you have gathered so far and from the things that you aspire to learn, what is the advice that you can give to the Sri Lankan youth watching this program?
So always education. I'm a big advocate for education. If you don't know something, you have your phone, you have Google, just search something. I'm not saying Google is always right, but it's good to search and learn about anything possible. So whenever I see something, even something, a subject matter, I would always go to Google and see to learn more. If I don't know something, if someone asks me something and I don't know about it, I would always say I would get back to you after going through it. So that's my outlook. So you should always go for education rather than just staying within your bubble. You should burst that bubble and search for more always.
Nice. So even I got inspired hearing you speak about education and you know how important it is to learn new things. So Amavin, I think the time we have for today's episode is up. So I would love to have spoken to you more about all the wonderful things that you do at the Urban Fishing Cat Project as well as in your academic career, which we had a short conversation before. So at the end, I would like you to, if you have any idea about like thanking your parents or the flow is yours.
Yeah, so I would actually love to thank my parents because they have brought me up in a way to be very open-minded and very confident with myself. As well as I would like to thank my teachers because they have always helped me through everything. And my friends, they have given me different takes on life. And I would especially like to thank Anya Ratnayake. She's the lead researcher of the Urban Fishing Cat Conservation Project, as well as Ashani and Madhuranga and my fellow interns for helping me learn more about science and to look at conservation and wildlife in a different perspective and to grow. So I would like to thank everyone who helped me through everything. Thank you.
Nice. So Amavin, we at NG Youth on the Move wish you all the best in your future endeavors. We hope you reach where you want to reach and be also very passionate and enjoy the ride up to that point. So thank you so much for joining us today, Amavin.
Thank you for inviting me.